And welcome back. Did I see a rooster or something? We are in Elm's Reach, of course. Just finished up looking through the blood sands at sacrifice chambers. I thought something interesting was going to happen here, like we found in the Hall of Warriors and in Noonfrost. But no, just people sacrificing people, and the people that are sacrificed are okay with being sacrificed, so far as I can tell. So that's that. So we are entering Tir Evron to pray for the god's strength with the blessings of Sheeda and Rhiannon, something, I don't know. Entree. So yeah, they're supposed to help us in our quest, give us strength to go into this pit of blades or spikes or something like that without dying horribly. Okay, so you just discovered three places at once and got a bunch of experience. Awesome. And nothing to be explored.
No problem.
Well, there's something over here. A luminescent Adra shard. Crisp flashes of light run through this Adra shard, pulsing in its faceted core like veins of light fueled by the heart of fire. Awesome. Shattered and charred stone blocks the passage into sun and shadow. So, you know, it couldn't be that easy. 10 years of dawn. Selected correspondences of Giftbringer Eden. And the enigmatic god of cold. All of which we have. But we can sell the extra copies. Final journal of Jonas. Missives of the Hand Occult. And the Many Faces of Barath. Ditto. Thanks for the library. Book of the Hunt, Daily Affirmations of Focus and Efficiency, Excerpts from the Sermon of Struggle, The Midwife's Memoirs, and The Queen That Was and Still Is. We have all those as well, but we'll sell them. Okay. I'm not sure what to do. Maybe we approach this. Oh! You know, when I hit tab... Oh, never mind. It does show up. Hello.
Magnificent.
Awesome. Oh, there's all the gods. What about this? Before this shrine sits the constellation of a snarling hound, Fares Bang Baird. Average adventure and. Okay. Throwing in mundane things like this. Assign Sagani to that. Oh, there's, we can look at these too. We got experience for each one. This shrine sits before a bright constellation, its stars forming the oval shape of an egg. A pair of wings sprout from the egg, stretching out to either side. Okay, so this is Helia. Barath. In the glittering stars of the nearby constellation, you see a grim shape of a skull. Its jaws are open wide as if frozen in a silent scream. A piercing ring fills your ears as you near Whale's shrine. There's no other response. Huh, I wonder why not. Can't look at that one either. In the nearby constellation, you can make out the shape of a strange horned beast. From time to time, you think you feel a, you sense a faint chill emanating from the shrine itself. That's for Rumorgand. Nothing happens when you approach Whitaker's shrine. So, aren't we supposed to pray to Helia? Oh no, that's Helia's temple above. Okay. Who should we pray to? Does it make a difference? Deities. So Barath is the god of death, cycles, doorways, mortality, and inevitability. The keeper of the cycle of life and death, Barath is thought to seek to claim the lives of those who have lived past their time. According to folklore, Barath is seen most often in the form of the Pallid Knight or the Usher, two skeletal characters who lead such people to their deaths by way of challenge or trickery. I don't know about that. Galawain, god of the hunt, assassins, pursuit, wilderness, and predatory creatures, sometimes thought to take the form of a fur-clad hunter or of a great hound. Galawain favors the survival of the strong and the culling of the weak. Helia, goddess of the sky, maternity, creativity, birds, song, invention, language, and the arts. Not known to take a particular physical form, but thought to be present in birds of all kinds. Rumorgand, god of entropy, cold, winter, bad luck, famine, and natural disasters. Manifests as a giant albino aurochs? Moving amidst a great blizzard, and in the plodding footsteps of Rumorgand come death and destruction. Magrin. Magrin's one of the ones, I think. Goddess of war, fire, transformation, purification, consumption, and trials. Patron goddess of the Deerwood. Thought to have blessed the Godhammer bomb that destroyed Widewind and possibly Aethys. Okay, so that's Galawain, that's Hylia. We can't pray to Magrin. There's Barath. Rumorgand. I'm kind of liking Galawain then. Pray to Galawain. You'll kneel before the shrine and prepare to recite the ritual words. I don't know the ritual words. What if I say the wrong thing? Like, I'm curious to see what happens. And if we die horribly, I mean, we haven't been playing that long. I could easily just run back in here from when we started the episode. So this is the other... Who is it? Not Rumorgand. And not Magrin. I forget. The first one we looked at, there was life and death, and death and life. What if we say that? Your words seem to fade once voiced, as if they were cast into a vast emptiness. The hall grows deathly still and silent, and then the ground starts to tremble beneath your feet. That's a wolf. Okay. He was not happy about that. And there's a stag. Anything else around? Right. So he's on B. I want him to be on A. How do I change that? Damn. I want to switch to A. I can't see a stag being that difficult. And then we'll take care of the wolf.
Pray thou do not kill me.
Okay, kinda tough. Oh, wow.
Mowing.
Try this minor blight, see what happens.
That's not...
That's not helpful. Did you cast it?
That's
not helpful. Huh.
Following your lead.
Okay, now he'll switch to that. Okay, I just gotta have it set beforehand. Learning Canis spells for the first time. I didn't even track his phrases. I didn't figure this would be a long combat, and it wasn't, so. Alright, let's look up Galawain. God of the hunt, assassins, pursuit, wilderness, predatory creatures. The survival of the strong and the culling of the weak. Ooh. As you kneel in front of the shrine, you feel yourself pushed forward. You catch yourself on your hands and knees, feeling warm, damp ground beneath them. Looking around, you find yourself crouched in a clearing in the middle of a woods. The smell of dirt hangs heavy in the air. You feel certain this is a vision, but the hairs on the nape of your neck still rise. Something leaps from the bushes. You find yourself pinned on your back and staring into the amber eyes of a massive hound. The beast looks at you. Gleaming fangs protrude from the sides of its mouth. Its nose twitches as it inhales your scent, starting at your shoulder and proceeding down the length of your arm. You follow its nose to your hand, which is covered in blood. A tongue as red as meaty as a steak lolls out of its mouth and swipes your bloody hand. Its lips curl into what looks like a smile. Friendly or happy because you're going to eat me? The beast looks back at you, and as it fixes you with its glowing eyes, its muzzle retreats into a long bearded face, and its pointed ears lengthen, dropping to the sides of its head. What was a massive hound becomes a giant of a man, his broad, muscled shoulders draped with furs. He holds a flint knife to your neck and grins, revealing a row of long, pointed teeth. Palagina says, that's one way to make an introduction, I suppose.
The lioness reigns still, and soon her cubs will rise. Why did you strike the bear down?
His voice is a growling whisper. Oh, the bear in the Galloway's maw. I think three fits this god's philosophy. If Oernos could not seize his victory, he did not deserve it.
Worthiness is proven in conflict. Might grappling with might. Flesh tears, bones break, and the ones that mend are stronger still. Blood mixes, and the worthier substance rises to the top. And you have proven worthy.
The changeling throws his head back and closes his eyes, breathing deeply of the cool air. He lets out a howl that rings through the air. He lowers his head, puffs of steam rising from his panting mouth. Twigs crunch and branches snap. The ground shivers under the weight of pacing, prowling footsteps. A dozen beasts, bears, wolves, and long-fanged cats stalk out of the undergrowth, their matching amber eyes fast on you. Alos takes a step back from the beasts. Just how real do you think this is? As the beasts encircle you, their master rises to his feet. Even the largest of the bears can only reach his browned and muscle-knotted shoulders. You stand, mindful of the ring of predators surrounding you.
You sought and won the favor of Galawain. What new prey do you now pursue?
You already know who I'm looking for.
To track a quarry, you must understand its movements. And Theos follows the path of a more powerful master.
Galawain, the changeling, bares his sharpened teeth again. A warm breeze carries the smell of smoke and gunpowder. Sparks ignite and float in the draft, catching in the leaves over Galloway's head. A sudden blast of heat scalds your face, and even as you turn away, a flash of light sears your vision through your eyelids. When you look back, you see a woman in full plate standing next to Galloway. Her mirror-polished armor flickers with images of reflected flames. You can't see her face, but her voice is strong and clear like the ringing of steel.
Let her know her foe.
Magrin. Of course Durance is going to speak up. The whore breaks her silence at last. Have you missed me, Magrin? You may have found other lovers, but surely none that was my equal. Magrin says nothing in response. Indeed, she never even glances in Durance's direction. An involuntary tick causes the baggy skin beneath Durance's eyes to quiver. He says no more, his ruddy skin blanched white. His poor Durance.
Theos has trapped thousands of souls in sun and shadow, like rabbits in a snare. Now, he goes there to retrieve the kill for his master, Woodica.
Woodica is behind all this after all, actually? I mean, can't be that much of a surprise. I mean, they're all praying in his temples, but Woodica's involved personally or in his name? One of the bears paws at the ground in irritation, its hackles rising. I mean, if Woodica himself is behind this?
She will feast on them, suck their marrow, grow strong on their essence.
The god closes his eyes and inhales deeply. As a Stelgar watches you, it licks its lips, its tongue scraping long fangs. Why would Theos help Woodica?
Because he is her hound. He has always done her bidding.
His eyes dart to another figure standing just behind Magrin.
Woodica stands for an old order. So does Theos.
Magrin's helm pivots sharply toward him. Abaddon. A golem made of blackened, pitted iron steps out of Magrin's shadow. Its movements are slow yet precise, each footfall accompanied by the groaning and grinding of metal. The steady orange glow of furnace coals emanates from its eye sockets.
They both fear change, and the Deerwood has changed much recently. People find answers not in the gods, but in animancy, the product of their own labors.
A gear clicks within its jaw, and Abaddon speaks.
And why not? When they have learned that even a god can be killed.
Reflected flames shiver in Magrin's armor. Adair says, she says that like it wasn't her followers that unleashed the godhammer. What should I do about it?
Track Theos. Follow the trail he has left for you, and corner him in sun and shadow.
You must stop him before he empowers Whittaker.
And if you do, you will have a different decision to make.
Gears whir and clank as Abaddon gives you a slow nod. Pelagina narrows her eyes. Experience with superior officers tell me this decision has a right and a wrongful answer as far as the lot of you are concerned. I know, I can't talk like her. Sorry.
Souls were ripped from the world, ripe and full and pulsing with essence. Scatter them like bones to a pack of dogs. Their essence will strengthen the souls of the Deerwood. Let the remains of the dead feed the survivors.
Why would I feed the lost soul's essence to the rest of the Deerwood?
To breed strength. Power is born from the mixing of essence and blood.
The wolves snarl and snap.
What Theos did cannot be undone. Thousands of lives have changed, and thousands more have ended because of his actions. But transformation gives purpose to trial.
A plume of flame ripples across Magrin's breastplate.
And improvement is the goal of all Kith. Long lives, prosperous futures, stronger minds and bodies. Strengthening those who remain will help repair the damage that Theos has done to the Deerwood.
I actually don't agree with this, but I'm not done talking to them, and I want to see what they'll say. If Whittaker can accomplish this, then perhaps she deserves her victory. The bear at Galawain's side rises on its hind legs and roars. It falls back on all fours with a ground-shaking thud. Galawain points his chipped flint dagger at you. Oops.
A victory that leaves her ruler of all. No room for conflict, no struggle, not even between the gods.
Be careful what you wish for, mortal. Whittaker's ways are regressive. Her laws never change, her authority never ebbs, and she never forgets a slight.
Whittaker would crush the Deerwood simply out of vengeance for the rebellion against Adir, her favorite. She would stamp out animancers, godslayers from the Saints' War, and anyone else she viewed as heretical or dangerous.
Adair says, it'd be justice for the Purges to see some of the persecutors face her wrath, but not the right kind of justice. Not the kind that heals. Okay, now I've got to find Theos.
And when you descend the pit to sun in shadow, you can count on our assistance to see you safely through. As I hope we can count on yours when you reach the bottom. There are many souls upon the burial isle that are sworn to serve us. They belong to you now, and they shall guide your descent.
Durance's face is grave. Beware the promises of a god watcher. They are binding, but only in one direction. The beasts grow restless, pawing the ground and eyeing you with renewed interest. The bear sniffs at the ground next to your leg. One Stelgar skulks into the circle, its amber eyes glowing. Galawain hurls his knife between your feet, sinking it to its handle. He raises his empty hand.
Hunt him, mortal. And when you stop him, let the souls he has captured feed the dear wood.
Strengthen the souls of those who remain. Prepare them to face the challenges that will follow. Pledge that you will do this, and we will grant you a power fit for the finest warrior who ever lived.
Sounds pretty awesome.
Betray us and my beasts shall track you down. Our allegiance is not to be accepted and cast aside.
Huh. Really? We can listen to the others? I would hear what the other gods have to say first.
Consider and calculate, but decide.
Awesome. You know, I thought we could only go one way, you know, and I was like, should I check out the others and, you know, restore the save and make it into, you know, deleted scenes or something. But we can actually hear what the others had to say. Well, that's pretty awesome. Galloway's hand falls and the growling pack lunges into the circle. The vision vanishes in an instant, returning you to Tir Evron, where burning candles replace the glowing eyes of Galloway's beasts. Okay. Learning that Whitaker is responsible for Widewind's legacy leaves many questions about the circumstances of the Saints' War and the destruction of Aethys. Durance may have further insight. Now that I have divine favor, I can travel to the Burial Isle and pursue Theos. It seems, however, that the gods are willing to offer great power in exchange for a promise to deal with the stolen souls in a manner of their choosing. There would, however, be a price for betrayal. I have learned that the Burial Isle can be reached from Old Song. Okay, so each of them is going to want something or another. So he wants us to let the souls, you know, go into the Deerwood. However the hell we would do that. Let's talk to Durance.
What?
You heard me.
What is it, Watcher?
Durance doesn't even seem to recognize you for a second, then blinks, frowns. Does what we learned about Whitaker trouble you?
It stinks of her. It is justice, but if her greater purpose was to think Margaren would fall prey to such deceit. And Aethys. Widewind had always claimed to be invading Deerwood to free it. What if it were true? What if he had come to stop Whitaker's plot before it began?
Interesting.
Surely Aethys earned his death at Godhammer Citadel, but not for those reasons. Not to keep him silent. If such a thing has brought about this chaos...
Durance tilts his head as if listening to an inner voice. Then he frowns, the frown deepening as he speaks.
Must we always be tools of gods? If Whitaker and Margaren, if they are the cause of this, the Hollowborn, if the purges were never necessary, if Aethys was fighting back...
Durance's face collapses in fury, his body shaking. This is a hard revelation, which I think he's already coming to. I've already asked him about the purges. Yeah, let's go. Go for it. Then your Godhammer didn't save Deerwood. It doomed it.
So many lies. And Whitaker. Perhaps she is the next god to fall beneath the Godhammer.
Durance's body continues to shake, his hands clenching white into fists. Sweat builds, streaming down the sides of his face. Would it have been better had you been spared this knowledge?
No, it... I am glad to have walked this far with you, seen this truth. Perhaps it was what I was meant to see, with a watcher's eyes.
He glances at you beneath his brows, warily.
All these dances of words and intrigues, machines of men, twisted, ripping the souls of children, and by the gods, the goddess of justice. If I could end her like Aethys, I... Margrin burned her once. One can do so again. Woodica, she must answer to her own justice.
His face darkens. Justice or revenge?
Anyone with a shred of spirit seeks both justice and punishment. It burns in the heart of anyone who lives. All seek it. If the world does not balance, we all drown in the oceans. And the gods would not care. Margrin, she must be redeemed. And punishing Woodica, that will serve.
Is that true? Margrin was allied with Woodica? She tried to kill all the makers of the Godhammer.
Is this some final joke at my expense? To test my faith further? And why would you think that, Watcher?
Durance looks at you for a moment, then his lip peels back, sneering. He laughs, loud and harsh. He didn't actually laugh. The others who made the Godhammer, they all died, didn't they? That's why I saw their symbols fade from your staff.
If all you have are questions, then I have enough of those. She is a bitch of a goddess, to be sure. But even a whore only goes so far in crossing those she serves.
Durance frowns, and his smile dies as he stares at you. You said you left Asphall without telling anyone of your departure?
You answer a question with a question. Then why did I feel her disappointment at Halgott? Why were we shamed?
Durance is silent for a moment, and when he speaks again, he speaks low and slowly, almost carefully. Is that true? You know, I wouldn't even choose this if this wasn't all multiple choice. Yeah, that's pretty profound. I wonder if that's true. Because I think she tried to kill you there.
Kill me? She is a goddess. I still drink from her burning breasts, Watcher. If she wished me dead, she could trace me to my source and kill me.
Durance looks at you for a moment as if you're mad, then his lip peels back, sneering. He laughs, loud and harsh. His face burns and his hand clenches tight on the staff. In the dream of the Godhammer, your spirit looked blurred, indistinct in the light, as if it had been sheared from you. Durance stares at you, his expression frozen, but he's silent, listening. This is pretty frickin' awesome. 2 and 3 are both good answers. One's more specific than the other, but I think they're both true. If you had been damaged as I saw in the Godhammer vision, then she may be unable to see you as you once were. Durance turns from you for a moment, his face twists in thought, conflicting emotions running across his features. Finally, he turns to you, his face steady.
There's no proof, Watcher. I was a fool to think you could help me see any farther than I could.
If you don't trust me, then trust your staff. Admit that the other Godhammer builders are dead. Durance turns to the staff, and for a moment you see his eyes burning, taking in the edges of the wood, the symbols inlaid there, the 11 faded circles.
They died in the blast, yes, the other 11. I was the only one to walk away. I thought we had wronged our goddess, that this was my trial, and if I could prove myself worthy of her, I should have known better. There is only one god of redemption, and I saw him ended.
I'm not completely sure that the truth is a good thing to be going through. I mean, can he still use his power if he's not following her? And he might even just give up and leave the group. I don't know where this is going, guys. As he studies the staff, you feel a wave of heat, a terrible energy rolling forth from it in waves, so much so it feels as if the godhammer itself is alive in his hands. And past it, you hear a cry like a child being born, and your eyes feel the flash of white. Then 100 imagined shades of purple and white, streaming and circling into the howling of a storm, and beneath it, the grinding of ancient machines of stone, rock, and metal, grinding and turning until all around you feels as if it's burning, sinking into the shadows of the earth, beneath the ground, the only place where a spirit might find refuge. My God. When your vision clears, you see Durance, his hands clutching the staff, and his eyes are bright, burning red. Atop the staff, the flame burns clearly, brightly. As his gaze burns, he rips his gaze away and howls, a bellowing, horrid howl like a wounded animal, and sweat pours down his brow. Durance, we can make this right.
To think I served her. I followed her. Now I shall serve no one. Whittaker's lies must be answered. And now it seems I must take fire and war from a goddess's false claim as well. I still take from her strength as I did, for as long as it lasts. For I shall not cast her aside yet, until I have drained her dry and had my fill, just as she intended for me.
Good, and that shows us that he's not putting aside the cleric's staff just yet. Durance's face cracks into a snarl. His face becomes stone, his eyes still burning, almost hungrily.
For I have learned one of the lessons of the faithful. The faithful may wound a goddess greater than any enemy. A purification is coming, and this fire shall consume them both. If doubts and curiosity plague you, you're skinning your knuckles on the wrong door.
I wonder what he has to say about Magrin now. Tell me about Magrin. God, you are swelling with questions. One would think you were with child or burning up inside. I was able to get Durance to see that Magrin had conspired with Whittaker in creating the Godhammer, and that her refusing to speak with him wasn't because he had wronged her, but rather because she had intended him to die with the other Godhammer engineers, in order to keep secret her direct involvement in Aethys' destruction. Though it appears this alliance between the goddesses was short-lived, it sheds new light on the Saints' War and the epidemic of hollowborn infants that followed. Durance, for his part, has renounced his goddess and sworn revenge. As a man who's killed one god already, it would seem he might be one of the only people alive that could make good on such a threat. Wow. It's a different boss battle if I ever heard of one. Sagani. You know, what you're doing right now is like nothing. Okay, I'm going to cut it short here. We have some other gods to talk to. So, and before I make a final choice, I'm going to talk to all my companions and see if any of them have anything to say. I mean, it's not fair. Only Durance gets to say something about what's going on. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.